Today, we'll be playing as Lucy MacLean from the Fallout TV show by unlocking a new weapon that she gets in the show every time we complete a mission. Also, obviously, spoiler warning if you haven't watched the whole show.
You know, I just noticed that a lot of the vaults don't have this style where you lower yourself down. Even in 76 as a game, the Vault 76 is like the traditional style like it is in the show. Which is really weird that this is one of the only vaults that lowers down like that. Alright, so we're not going to help Codsworth because her history with those robots is terrible if you've seen the show. We're going straight to, I almost said Quahog, Concord. And the first two weapons we get to do this mission are these two, the syringe rifle and the combat knife. She herself never gets to really have dog meat with her, if I'm remembering correctly. So we're going to skip dog meat. I've never actually used a syringe rifle. Does it not work on bugs? Uh-oh. Why is dog meat out here? I've never seen him go this far out. Please tell me I didn't shoot him with this. Is that why he's green? Oh no. I hope it was the bugs. Alright, until we clear out Concord, we cannot get our third weapon, which is probably one of the best weapons we can have, besides maybe one other in the entire list. It's the best melee weapon for sure, and will 100% replace our combat knife. Alright, let's test this. Ooh, look at their health ball. One shot? Oh, one shot. Okay. Oh, I can't be grabbing stuff like that. Crap. It's such an instinct after playing this game so many times. How'd that miss? She herself never really uses VATS either. He does. The ghoul does in one scene. At least that's what the effect gives off. When he shoots a bullet and it like does a slow-mo. How is this thing so bad at hitting? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Preston. I can't believe I said that, but thank you, Preston. Alright, what item did I pick up that I can't have? Yeah, I can't have that. No Molotov cocktail for me. We're gonna stay in the jumpsuit, by the way, because annoyingly, she does not ever change out of the jumpsuit more than one time. Does 10 years in the future say mean that the Minutemen are around? Because I think Fallout 4 takes 10 years, is 10 years before the Amazon show is. Right away. She does get right away once. And she drinks dirty water, so you know what? We're good. And she's offered iguana, which is close to squirrel, so, you know, we're getting there. Hello. Oh, you forgot it's not instant. Yeah, you'll be dead in a second, don't worry. There you go. The only thing that's a little annoying about the gun is it is not instant. We could use a combat knife on our next one. Right here. On this guy. There we go. Ow. Okay. Actually, ow. Hold on. That missed. No, I'm not gonna die here. I'm just not. I forgot. It's why did Todd Howard think the best number for a stim pack is zero? No aid for me? That's crazy.
Glad to help.
Well, if that's true.
That is really her attitude the whole series. Glad to help.
The rules say that you cannot actually do any of these shootings that you're doing because it is an act of aggression.
Why can I not skip Sturge's dialogue, please?
Actually, you also deal with criminals, obviously, because you stole this perception bobblehead from Vault Tech.
Alright, once we get down to fight the Deathclaw, that'll be weapon number two. Though I will not be using the power armor because Lucy never uses it. So this fight will be very difficult. This is a good time to show her second weapon. She never actually uses it as a weapon. She more just uses it to take someone's head off, but you know, good time to have it. All right, so this is gonna suck for the fall because I can't use power armor. Ow. And what I need to do is an old strat, which is get this Deathclaw immediately out to fight the Raiders, because without power armor, especially ice and a minigun, I stand no chance here. There he is. Go deal with the Deathclaw, please. Hopefully he's not after me. He's not. That's good. All right. So, my plan for this is a quick save and use the syringe to hopefully take him out slowly but surely. And that did hit. So, that's good. It looks like it's still taking effect, which is really good. I don't know how much this does, but a lot, apparently. Double the damage. Oh, he's almost dead. Finish him off. Oh, don't grab me. No. This is an instant death, right? Oh, he died. It's still the animation to throw me still went out. There's still a raider left. You want your head cut off? That'd be cool. I heard it's valuable in these parts. Hey, come here, buddy. Perfect. Now I just got to deliver you to the NCR. And from Preston, we will get our that next weapon, which is what she gets in episode 4. All right, as we make our way to Diamond City, we unlock the weapon she has in episode 4, which is a 10mm pistol. She didn't have the scope on it, but like I couldn't find an ID with one that is just plain, so we're going to make do. But you know, she has a 10mm pistol for a short while. So we got to make our way to Diamond City before we can do anything else. That backpack is so cool and so well done, I can't even lie. Look at this. Oh, hello. Where's Preston? Dragging his butt, whistling, of course. So, to unlock the next weapon, I have to do a quest. And one, is this beach ball always here? Welcome to ADHD in a nutshell. I could either go all the way to Diamond City and count that as a quest, or I could do the first step. And you might be saying, like, the first step takes forever. Why would you want to go all the way through all of clearing out all of those raiders and everything? Well, you don't actually have to. And as I thought about it, I just realized playing Lucy, she would never do what I'm about to do and skip this quest line. So I guess we're headed all the way to Diamond City. And it is kind of similar to what she has to do, where you have to walk a really far away. So I guess we're going all the way to Diamond City before we get the second to last weapon, I believe it is, that she gets. By the way, I'm just curious how a bunch of you felt about the show, because I actually, as someone who plays the games, really enjoyed it. There wasn't too much to nitpick. The only thing I thought was kind of weird was that, like, there was a lot of grotesque stuff in the show, like, overly grotesque. And normally it's fine with me. I just was like, what is it adding to these scenes being, like, so unbelievably disgusting in some scenes? Like, some things were cool, like the gulper being a little bit different, having fingers. I don't believe the gulper in Fallout Far Harbor has fingers as tongues, so that was a cool little change. But, like, the foot. And some of you guys know what I'm talking about. It was just gross. And it felt like it was more just gross for being gross. But that is such a minor thing to nitpick a show about a game. Especially knowing about the history about games and shows. Combinations have been really bad recently. Except for like The Last of Us and League. So to get a really, really good show for Fallout is awesome. And the fact that that is the only nitpick that I have is pretty good. Besides maybe some minor weird plot. Like, what is this character doing this for type things, but I'm sure they're like, I'm sure it'll be explained in general later on. Oop, hello. Oh, my aim. Oh, hold on. Wait, I get to use this now. Oh, wait. There we go. Cool. I'm sure those plot holes and everything will get sorted out in the next season. By the way, of course, if you're going in the comment section, be careful because someone might spoil some stuff. So be mindful going down there as well. Whoa, what was that? Sounded like something fell next to me. Oh, what the? Who are you? Hello?
Excuse me.
Sorry, don't have anything to sell. I'm on my way to Vault 81 to restock. Maybe you can find what you need there.
Is this the Vault 81? Is it? Huh? Is this the Vault 81 side, like, that pushes you to Vault 81 in a way? I don't even know who that is. I'll be honest. Alright, through the rat invest in water. Away! One thing I really did appreciate about the show was, like, the sound that they used for literally everything was pretty much accurate across the board. Besides maybe one or two things. If that. Like, it seemed pretty much perfectly accurate to the rad sounds, the Pip-Boy noises, pretty much everything. And I think having taught Howard there helped. Okay, I'm in trouble. No! I can't use vats, because she doesn't use vats ever. Yeah, Lucy's got it down. Are there more? I think there's another one over there. I'm just gonna go this way. Come on, Lucy, let's go. Also, I couldn't get the exact hair that she has, because, you know, limited hair and all that. And the looks menu mod didn't work for me, so this is what we got. Still turned out pretty good, I think. Let's try the... Actually, it's fringe rifle ain't gonna do anything. There we go, headshot. Beautiful. I think we're near the super mutant fight. Wait a minute, does this count as a quest here? Does this help? Is helping Diamond City help us count as a quest? No, I don't think so. Alright, we're not helping them then. Excuse me, just run through a battlefield, no need to worry. Oh, what? Oh, okay, I thought those were ghouls. I was like, what are ghouls doing back here? Welcome to Philly! Spelled with an F for some reason. Alright, so we get our next weapon, which is a grenade. And you might think, she never uses a grenade in the show. She doesn't use it on camera, but she talks about wanting to use one that she has in the scene where she says, near the very end of the show, one night I tried to stuff a grenade in the neck hole to blow you all up, but I didn't do that. So, we get grenades. So now we have frag grenades. She talked about it, therefore she has it, apparently. That's how that works, 100%. So, if we go to her office, we get the last weapon.
Sure.
I'm only doing the interview so I can get my last weapon. And the last weapon she gets in the season, in the very last episode, one of the last scenes. So, by the way, if you have not watched season 8, put this video on hold. Season 8? Jesus. Episode 8. Put this episode on hold and watch later until you do. But she gets a classic 10mm pistol, and like the basic one, because it has the revolver side on it. And Piper, shush. Leave your office. Sir, this is an act of aggression, and I would like you to stop. And I think all of these people would prefer that I use force, because you're making the situation forceful. Thank. So it turns out the classic 10mm is a Creation Club item. So this will have to do.
You're safe now.
I didn't even know you could talk to this guy. Okay, well, only one thing left to do. In season 2, Lucy's gonna go insane, so